This could be the biggest breakthrough in SIDS research in a long time, or is it? A new study published on May the 6th in the journal eBiomedicine is causing a stir among parents, and there's some pretty huge claims being made on social media and in articles around the internet, some of which frankly are inaccurate and even potentially harmful. So in this video, I'm going to break down what this research really means, how much of a breakthrough it actually is, and everything else you need to know about it. Firstly, let's talk about the study completed by Dr. Harrington and her team. These researchers measured the level of an enzyme, which is referred to as BCHE, in the blood of 67 babies in Australia who died of SIDS. And what they found is that the babies who died of SIDS had significantly lower levels of BHCE than babies who did not die from SIDS. Now, this finding is very interesting, as low levels of this enzyme would actually reduce a sleeping infant's ability to wake up or respond to its environments, and this would increase their risk of SIDS. So for example, usually when a baby experiences a life-threatening situation, such as having difficulty breathing while they're sleeping, they will wake up and cry out for help. But for babies with low levels of BHCE, they don't have the same arousal response and they will stay in this compromised position. Based on these findings, the researchers concluded that the enzyme BHCE could actually be a potential biomarker to help identify newborn babies who are at risk of SIDS. Now, some people have interpreted these findings to mean that Dr. Harrington and her team have identified the cause of SIDS. While at first glance this might seem like a reasonable conclusion, it's simply not accurate. But before I explain why, make sure you download a copy of my free Parents Guide to Naps by clicking the link in the description if you haven't already. This will help to make nap times much easier for you and your baby. So even Dr. Harrington and her team acknowledge that this study is not definitive by titling their paper, BHCE is a potential biomarker for sudden infant death syndrome, not BHCE is a definitive biomarker for sudden infant death syndrome. In fact, Dr. Harrington stated more research is needed to determine whether BHCE tests would be an effective way to identify infants at risk of SIDS and prevent future deaths. Medical experts have also urged people to be cautious for a number of reasons. Firstly, the lab samples tested were more than 2 years old, and the enzyme levels may have changed since the time of collection. Secondly, the only coroner diagnoses, not autopsy findings, were used to determine which deaths were classified as SIDS. The findings also included data on children up to the age of 2, but a SIDS diagnosis is only given to a baby who dies under the age of 1. And the sample size itself was relatively small, with 67 cases of children who had died from SIDS and 10 controls, so these were 10 living cases. What they did find is that some of the infants in that control group did have low levels of BHCE, but they did not develop SIDS. Due to this small sample size and the conflicting findings in that control group, it's clear that much more research is needed to know if these findings are in fact conclusive in a larger group of infants. Furthermore, it's important to note that this study is only a small piece to a very large puzzle for SIDS. And this is because current research indicates that SIDS is not due to one factor, rather it occurs when multiple factors happen at the same time, which is explained in the triple risk model. So according to this model, SIDS occurs when three factors occur simultaneously. The first factor is a vulnerable infant. So the infant themselves might have an underlying vulnerability that puts them at risk for SIDS. So this might be that they have low BHCE, or the baby might have been born prematurely. They may have been a male. They might have a low birth weight. The baby may have been exposed to tobacco smoke or illicit drugs in utero, or there may be a genetic component. The second factor is a critical developmental period for homeostatic control. So this simply means that the infant is under 6 months of age, because we know that around 90% of SIDS death occur in the first 6 months of a baby's life, with it peaking at around 2 to 4 months of age, and few babies die in that first month. And the third factor is there is an exogenous stressor or external stressor. So these include environmental factors like sleeping a baby on their belly or on a soft sleeping surface, using a pillow, bed sharing, or accidental overheating. So when these three factors overlap, there is the greatest risk of sudden and unexpected death in infants, including SIDS. Given that SIDS occurs when these three factors overlap, the findings by Dr. Harrington and her team may offer a small hint at what might be a potential biomarker that makes an infant vulnerable to SIDS. But it will not eradicate SIDS, nor does it lower the importance of creating a safe sleep environment. It's important that we continue to eliminate environmental elements which are known risk factors for SIDS and follow the safe sleeping practices, as well as keep unsafe baby sleeping products well away from our baby's sleeping spaces. Watch this video next to find out which products you should never have in your baby's crib. Many of these are marketed as essential items, but are actually completely unnecessary and can increase the risk of SIDS for your baby.